Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance Series. Happy Monday, Mosh Pit. I hope your weeks have gone off to an awesome start here. We have an awesome meme of the day as requested by, well, me. We have ourselves the Repentance Eden Run Dunk Rating List brought to you by JasonAder53. Title thread was, I made an unofficial official Repentance Eden Run Dunk Rating chart, and there's so much to go over here. You can either pause the video and full screen it, or what I highly recommend doing is actually going to the Invicta subreddit and seeing everything for yourself, because the JasonAder put in a lot of detail on here. So many good references, I can't even begin to describe them all. So thank you very much, JasonAder. We'll be using this one from now on for a while until there's an official one. I like this one though a lot. So let's hop on in and get rocking and rolling on the brand new work week here in the Mosh Pit. Oh boy. He is going to be Romeo Kilo, Delta, Juliet, Hotel, Charlie, Papa, Papa. I feel like we've had this seed before. We've got Tropicamide along with having Jello. Very bad tiers. Good damage, though. 3.71, ain't too bad. Horrible movement speed, though. Yeah. I mean, Tropicamide, here's the thing about Tropicamide. It makes you look like you've got good damage when you don't. Also, I need to move my camera that I use for the card openings, because it's like in the way, like blocking like half of the screen right now. Somehow, like I use this giant tripod. There we go. Sorry about that. I use this giant tripod that I use for the camera, and it works to a certain extent, but like it takes up so much space, and on top of that, like the camera setup that I've got is like really heavy, so the camera like weighs it down, so I can't keep it at like a proper height, and it just kind of like sinks further and further until it's like just directly across my line of vision. You might be able to get this one. Oh, I'm not sure if that was gonna hit or not. That would be close of the super secret room. We do have Jello though. Jello is an item that, you know, a lot of people like. I think that Jello would be a lot better if you could use it just like Tainted Lilith can, which is just like continually just fire it over and over and over again. But, I mean, you know, Jello does act as sort of like a, it's almost like a remote incubus in a way. So, you know, if you need it in a bind, Jello's not too bad. If you just need a little bit of extra oomph, a little bit of extra DPS, I'm going to use a bomb here to get one key. Ooh, we'll get the Swallowed Penny as well. And oh, baby, we've got Suplex. Oh, yeah, brother. Although we may not be holding on to it very long, depending on this library. I really want to get Bookworm here. Let's fight the boss first. I don't think that Suplex can stop us from taking damage on spikes. I don't think so, anyway. I could be wrong about that. But Suplex can stop us from taking damage in a curse room, though. So, or at least going through the doors, anyway. Ooh, yeah, brother! Okay, well, we'll get Mom's coin purse, of course. Let's go see if they're... The only apprehension I have about this is that the fact that we're going down to 1 HP. That's kind of a big no-no when you're going over spikes. But, I mean, I would obviously go immediately for the Bible, and then after that go and then use it, and then, you know, just fly to whatever. There you go. There we get a free entrance into the super secret room. M as well. We haven't used M in a while, but man, this is already kind of wacky. And there's also the glowing hourglass too. Oof, man, this is rough. I think what we do is we use M for Suplex. We can use M for Suplex over the spikes, pick up the Bible, use it, and then fly. Will that work? It will. Look at that. We didn't even take any damage. That's the even crazier part. So we can roll all these books with M here, which is kind of hilarious. So we are going to get Bookworm. We turn it to another teleporter. Not gonna get Bookworm, and that it gave us the Hierophant card, which M gave us Pandora's box, which gives us two more soul hearts. Okay, yeah, all right. Then we can buy the glowing hourglass and then use it immediately if we want to, and roll it with M, Or we can just roll with the Glowing Hourglass, which is just a safer play. Although we do have these pills inside of the boss room here, which means that we can take these pills without really any consequence unless we get telepilled out. This is just gonna be it's a chaotic start to an episode in a week. Okay, great.
Down. Telepills.
I don't think that was really worth it.
Something's wrong.
Okay, so we just want to take the health up. Okay. Good. Now that we've gotten that out of the way, we can finally go. So the thing with M is that M will basically roll your hearts, or your hearts. It will roll your space bar. I was looking at the heart. It will roll your space bar item every time you use it and turn it into a random space bar item. And that can be quite insane, as you just saw us get a floor one Pandora's box for free, basically. But it can also kind of ruin things in a way, because like it sometimes gives you something that like a Diplopia or a Plan C. One thing that you can use just one time only, and then that's it. Then your spacebar item is gone. So you got to be a little bit cautious using it, but I do like the chaotic nature of M to a certain degree. I'm going to use a bomb to go into the item room. But really what it comes down to is do we stay with M? And that I don't know, because I really like the Glowing Hourglass for defense. It allows you to undo everything and anything that goes bad. You can take pills without really too much to worry about, unless, of course, you get telepills with a golden pill like we did. Luckily, we were able to undo that because of the way that the new Glowing Hourglass works, which is having charges instead of like a full charge meter like it used to. So you're not totally screwed if you get telepills out of a room and you're just trying to experiment with pills or a golden pill or whatnot. Gonna take it nice and slow in here. Gotta be careful of the champion pooters. They will tag you. They'll get you. We still can go into the shop as well. And honestly, the sacrifice room is kind of looking a little bit tempting here. Normally, I would say the secret room is to the left of here, but we've already found the secret room, so I don't have to worry about that. Gotta watch out for the corn flies. Once you hit one corn fly, stick on that one. Otherwise, you're gonna get hit. I'm honestly shocked that spider lived through that. Okay. Red stew. Red stew is tempting because our damage is not great. But our damage is not terrible either for where we are right now, but it's not phenomenal. I'd like to get this tinted rock, please. And if there is nothing satisfactory in said tinted rock, I will undo all the bombs that we've used here. That's good. Squeezy. I mean, again, we needed a tears upgrade. So now the question becomes: do we go after the sacrifice room now that we've gotten Squeezy and actually have enough hearts to pay for it? On top of that, if we get an unsatisfactory result, we can just simply just undo everything with the Glowing Hourglass. We just need to drop M first. It's tempting because it does allow us to maybe get a pre-angel deal angel item without us even fighting the second boss. It is going to take a little while, though. I mean, these early game sacrifice room plays are time-consuming, admittedly. But, you know, if it takes a long time to do something, sometimes it's worth doing. That could be the new Mosh Pit shirt of the month right there. All right, so we're going to sit on these spikes and just see what happens here. 100% angel deal chance now. Okay. All right. Got teleported to the angel room. Man. We had a recent run where Immaculate Heart just wasn't doing it for me. That one absolutely will. Okay. That's, yeah. Floor 2 Sacred Heart. Yes, please. I'll go ahead and re-up for that every single time. So that is, that's a pretty good upgrade. Did lose our tears up that we got from Squeezy, unfortunately, but I think that it goes without saying, that's no big deal. We're totally fine with that. We did not get our HP back, unfortunately, but who cares? We've got Sacred Heart. Sacred Heart, 38 cents. I'm down for that. All right. Alrighty, so we can go pick up M again and start having some fun with the trinket. Sure. I guess we'll take Red Stew. It does give us a full heal, so, I mean, why not? Not sure where the Super Seeker Room is. I feel like it's right here, but I'm not 100% sure. Okay. Yep. So, yeah, with the Sacred Heart multiplier, I mean, the amount of damage that we're doing right now is just ludicrous. It's just... It is ludicrous. You do get a tears upgrade here from the screw. We've already been in here, obviously. I don't think that Immaculate Heart is a play. I really don't. I'll talk about it in a second. Really stark contrast to what we had last week here. At this time, I mean, last week's runs were very single item centric. And we're already starting off to a crazy run, especially with yesterday's insane, wacky Sunday run. But anyway, going over to Immaculate Heart, we had a couple runs last week on stream that were just awful. And Immaculate Heart really exposed itself to be not that useful for the damage that you get. The thing I don't like about Immaculate Heart is the thing that I've always sort of disliked about Immaculate Heart but tolerated. And that is the lack of direction when it comes to your shot. Lack of control of your shots, I think, is a better way to describe it. I mean direction, but not in the literal sense because it sounds weird. What I mean by that is basically I like to, whenever I shoot my shots, I like them to go straight or curve the way that I want them to and land on a target. I do not want them to just randomly just start rotating around Isaac's head and not get to the intended target as fast as possible, thereby exposing us to possible harm and damage when we're trying not to be. Got a devil deal here. Poor Babylon. Eh. I think we're already somewhere around a 6 on the dunk meter right now. But Immaculate Heart was causing lots of problems on last week's runs. And it compounded itself by also like being the only damage up that we had for a particular run that was not very good. Your soul. It's a golden your soul. I don't think it does anything different. Ooh, that is actually way better. Sorry, your soul. Sorry, M. We want a tears up here. Another sacrifice room with an eternal heart too to boot. But I've fallen out of well, Immaculate Heart has fallen out of the good graces with me. I don't think that it is worth the trouble or what would be a very admittedly good damage upgrade here combined with the Sacred Heart multiplier. I really don't like it. I don't like my tears just randomly rotating. It makes placing bombs very difficult as well, because they don't travel in a predictable trajectory around Isaac, or they go around randomly, I should say, around Isaac. And it's just an annoying item, man. Like, if we have piercing shots, then Immaculate Heart becomes a little bit more tolerable, I would say. Or if we're just like massively broken. And right now, we would have gotten a pretty big damage upgrade with the Sacred Heart multiplier. But again, I still am kind of annoyed with the item still. The bruises haven't healed yet. Reds do buff slowly ticking down here, but we're still just throwing boulders out left and right, one-shotting pretty much everything that we hit. I am all for. We're just gunning down for sake. And we get another devil deal here. We haven't even been to our item room yet. And all these red hearts honestly are making me definitely consider playing the sacrifice room again. And we also have this eternal heart, which will be greatly beneficial for us on the next floor too, if we're going for an angel build. Get a planetarium. Interesting. Yeah, soul. I mean, soul removes any curses, so. And it does also show us the location of the boss rooms. It's always nice. Iron bar gives us concussive tears, a little bit of a damage boost. Nothing to really write home about. All right, let's play the sacrifice room, and if something unsatisfactory happens, we can just simply undo it with the glowing hourglass. Wasn't expecting us to get taken there. Got fairly lucky on the first floor. Well, on the second floor, really. But, yeah, we can't expect too much there. We can also go check what's inside of the boss trap room with the glowing hourglass just to kind of take a peek, take a gander. Take us a little gander up in there. Go heal ourselves real quick. I can see Forever gives us the free access to the secret room and super secret rooms, but we've already found, well, the regular secret room. We don't know where the super secret room is yet. It's probably at the end of that long hallway room here. Or not. I'd take that back. I was incorrect. All right, almost back to full health. We should take a brief stop into the boss trap room. So there's the soul heart. There's the troll bombs. The Uriel. Actually mean to get hit there. Let's go take a look inside of the boss trap room here. It's guaranteed to at least be an HP upgrade at the bare minimum. Yeah, we'll take movement speed. We will take movement speed for show. Nice job by Iron Bar there. Basically concussing Gertie to the point of no return. Same thing goes for Dark One here. Yeah, that is just so much damage. World card, party time, excellent. I will go in the curse room. Wow, okay. That was unexpected, but I'll take it. And let's go grab the Eternal Heart here and also tap for one more time. 30 more cents. We didn't lose the Eternal Heart because we have the Soul Heart there. We don't need to fight Gabriel. There's just like literally no point for that. Good. So we are on a roll. We've got Steam Sale. We've got money. We've got Sacred Heart. We've got everything, man. Like, it's almost like a continuation of yesterday, actually. Curse of Darkness, who cares? We know where the boss is, thanks to Soul. As soon as we destroy the boss, that is going to clear the curses. The world. And we still have a chance, and it's an outside shot. But it's still a shot for us to go make boss rush. I can see forever. Again, we're taking pills because there's basically no risk there. We've got the glowing hourglass. Maggie's bow, oh my gosh. You're going to have so much HP. And you know what? I'm all for it, you know? So it was a rough weekend. Fun weekend, but rough weekend. Lots of stuff going on. Ready to start a brand new week. Everything gets back to, snaps back to reality. Oh, there goes something. And nope, there goes. I was never a big Eminem fan. I like Eminem, don't get me wrong. In fact, I think my favorite track by Eminem is probably Godzilla. And I'm not saying that just because, like, I'm just a massive Godzilla fan, but it's just because, like, it's a great song. I know that, like, maybe, like, Real Slim Shady or, like, Lose Yourself is probably, like, the go-to for some people. Like, Rap God. I think Rap God's pretty good, too. But there's just, there's something about the way that, that Godzilla comes together where I'm just like, man, I just love this track. But I wouldn't say that I'm a huge Eminem fan. I never bought any of his records. I never went to any of his concerts or anything. He comes out with a new track or two. I'm like, oh, hey, that's pretty good. That's fire. There you go. I'm going to take the tiers upgrade because we do not need any money. And we'll just keep on rolling, baby. Yeah, so we need to book it. We need to find the full card, but we have a good chance of catching back up time-wise and getting into boss rush and getting out of there scot-free. I think that probably it's got to be Godzilla. Like, I've always been a big fan of Till I Collapse as well. Even though that track got really, really heavily played out because it was just used in, like, every single video game trailer. Like, Call of Duty and, like, movie trailers and all this stuff. Like, it got played out, which was unfortunate because I was just like, man, like, I love Nate Dogg. He had one of my favorite voices in all of hip-hop and rap. Like, it was such an iconic voice that he had. Okay, we're not taking damage in this room. But that song did get that's a song that got ruined by commercials, unfortunately, and not ruined, but just like it's just like, man, I've heard this, like, it's no longer like a, oh, this is my track. Now it's like, oh, this is the Call of Duty Modern Warfare track. You know what I mean? Like, it gets claimed by, like, a company, and then it's just no longer fun to claim anymore. Another good example of that would be Blue Stolly, Ultranum. I listened to that song before most people in the world listened to that song. I've actually spoken with Blue Stolly. And then it was just used everywhere. And it's like, and it was very popular in the World of Warcraft PvP, like, trailers and editing scene. But once it appeared in, like, movie trailers, like, actual Hollywood movie trailers, I knew that was over. Like, man. Ultra Numb. Still a great song, though. There goes Mom. Soul gives us the full, clear side of the map here. And let's go into Boss Rush. And, yeah, that's... Those are four Space Bar items and a Boss Rush. Just... Give it up. Give it up. We'll take the bag of crafting just because I want to just waste time with it, I guess. Like, we don't need the glowing hourglass anymore. I think it's pretty obvious that we are not going to be in any kind of danger on this run at all. So we'll take the bag of crafting just because it's not an item that you see me use anymore, because I think it's actually pretty dog water, but we'll take it. Lots of keys. I don't want to waste all my keys. Notice how with the parasite, the little fractal tiers that are coming off of splitting from the main tiers. Notice how they're also Sacred Heart tiers, which is kind of awesome, because they have the homing properties. It's like hot in here. Started talking about Ultra Numb, and all of a sudden I'm like burning up. It's too early, man. It's just too early in the year for it to start getting, like, warm again. I don't like it. I know that, like, you know, we have, like, cold weather issues down here, but I'd still rather be cold than hot. Like, I'm not ready for spring. I'm not ready for summer. Please. The 80 to 90 to 100 degree weather, just, can you just wait, like, six more months? Then I'm fine. Like, that, I'm totally fine. You know, get around my birthday, then, hey, you know what? It can start getting warm again. But for now, like, just let me enjoy my cold weather. Let me enjoy my Skyrim weather. That's all I want. get Birthright here. And I will take Contract from Below. We'll buy Booster Pack. Judgment, eh. Don't really need to play this Judgment. I think I didn't see you over there. Yeah, Mani Pack's fine. Okay, so we have eight items inside of the bag of crafting now, so it's ready to go for crafting, and we make I had to take my sweatshirt off. It's warm. Cool down. Bag of crafting, by the way, if you don't know what it is an active item that you unlock after playing with Tainted Cain, and it's generally pretty bad. But it can be good. It can be good if you find the right combination of items. The problem is that you don't know what the items are going to create unless if you look at like external information mod and you want to like kind of cheat like that. But I think that it takes way too much time to look at that, and I would rather just kind of wing it. Heard a bomb somewhere. So the higher the tier of crafting components that you put in there, will guarantee like a certain level of item quality from the bag of crafting. But it's generally speaking, in my opinion, it's a very annoying item to use, basically because you don't want to have to go through. Yeah, we'll take that. I personally just don't like having to go through the hassle of like looking up recipes and all that stuff. Don't want the eraser. I mean, I'll stick with the bag of crafting, I guess. Like we're in an unlosable situation right now. But that's the thing with the bag of crafting, though, is just that life is like a bag of crafting. You never know what you're going to get. And it's laborious to use. You have to look up recipes or have the external information mod, which puts console players at a distinct disadvantage. And overall, my feeling on it is just that it's just not worth using. You know, why give up the bag of crafting? We can have, like, anything that you know what that item is going to do. Unless you're just trying to be wacky and kooky and crazy, then hey, go for it. But if you really want to sort of exemplify the problem that I have with bag of crafting, look no further than Tainted Cain just on the whole. He is, you know, a very big slog to play. Okay, good. Got a diamond there. Fortunately, we cannot take the left hand, which I wouldn't take anyway because we have, you know, cancer. You know, Tainted Cain is... Like, by people, I mean myself, talk about, you know, how much we don't like playing Tainted Jacob or Jacob and Esau or, you know, Tainted Lazarus, that sort of thing. But then when it becomes down to Tainted Cain, it's like, yeah, Tainted Cain is, it's not that he's a difficult character. He is just not fun to play. There's some people who swear up and down by Tainted Cain. I'm not one of them, though. I think he is just the most unfun character to play in Isaac. In a slew of unfun characters. Give me that Eternal Heart. Isn't it supposed to be... Oh, wait, no. Curse the Blind. Curse the Blind was cured by Soul. Why? Hey, that's right. I only briefly forgot that Soul clears curses. Yeah, why not? Again, I don't know what we're putting inside of the bag of crafting. We're just kind of winging it. Okay, that was neat. Didn't exactly move there. Now, back in the day, bag of crafting, and this is not really relevant anymore, but I've got nothing else to talk about. Back in the day, bag of crafting used to have static recipes. And at the time, a lot of people, myself included, felt that that was a little... It was kind of boring because, like... It would always result in you just crafting the same stuff over and over again, and then Tainted Cain was broken. Like, you could just make any item in the game because you knew the recipes. But at the same time, that allowed people to sort of retain the information and knowledge of what specific crafting recipes were, and it became fun. Because it's like, oh man, now, yes, I know I need only one more Eternal Heart, you know? Like, just one more Eternal Heart, and that's all, and then we're set to make Sacred Heart or whatever have you. But now, it's like, so that was too strong, according to Ed or Vin or whoever makes the balance changes over at Nicholas. So what they did was they made the bag of crafting recipes random, and it's tied to your seed. So the same effects, the same recipe components that you would use on one seed no longer make the same thing on a different seed. And that brought back the randomness, and, you know, and then that's sort of where we're at in this day and age, where you just don't know what the crafting recipes are going to do. And the more time that you spend trying to find out what they do, the less time it is that you have to make, like, achievements and whatnot. Like, Boss Rush and Tainted Cane, for example, is very difficult to do. So, if it were up to me, I would revert it back to the old bag of crafting, where you would be able, you'd be able to memorize the recipes to speed up your gameplay. There's legitimate strategies involved to say, okay, we got to drop some hearts inside of the secret room and give us a bone heart, for example, and that gets us a devil deal item, or, you know, like, there's a chain. It's like almost like a 6 degrees of separation level of strategy, which I think is really, really interesting. It's sure a hell of a lot more interesting than it is right now, in my opinion. Again, this is just my opinion. My opinion. Most people don't agree with it, and that's fine. I'm not asking you to. That will take Pogatory. I mean, everything and anything that gives us a damage upgrade is just going to be multiplied by a whole lot thanks to Sacred Heart. Movement speed is also, you know, welcome. So if you don't know what happened there, that was the Stars card taking us from the starting room to the starting room. Thank you, Stars card. Appreciate it. Very kind of you. Now, giving up all those red hearts is not necessarily the smartest thing to do, but keep in mind we also have the bag of crafting. So most likely, we are probably going to get that back in the way of just basic HP upgrades through accidental crafts. Tractor Beam and Parasite and Brittle Bones, or not Brittle Bones, but Compound Fracture is massive. That is so much damage that's going to be front-loaded into these little, like, into this beam of just death. There are certain times where, yeah, I mean, just look at that. Like, Lamb is, like, already dispatched. Second seed of the day, 1 Lima Mike Quebec Delta Papa Whiskey 8. I mean, Succubus is going to do tons of damage. We're already doing tons of damage. We get Parasitoid too. Oh boy. Yikes, that is a metric butt ton of damage we're doing. Our range is so high too. That's the thing. That's a weird thing about bag of crafting is that range upgrades also affect it. I'm getting rid of the bag of crafting just because, I mean, we have Mom's Box plus the cancer trinket. Yeah, sign me up. Instant death. Instantaneous death. We'll take the luck upgrade here. And the range, just because. But yeah, I mean, like, I've said my piece many, many, many times on bag of crafting, so I'm not going to dwell on it. And then the vault that we care about, and a forget-me-now. All right. God's flesh, I mean, sure. We are 99 cents right now, so we are in a good spot. I mean, compost ain't bad either with Parasitoid. I'm not gonna lie. compost is real strong with Parasitoid. I mean, I don't like not having the extra tiered effects from Mom's box, but at the same time though, like the sheer amount of damage that our tiers and everything are going to do is just absolutely wonky. What just happened to the angel stat? Whatever. All right, so we're gonna go back and use the Forget Me Now, but first we're gonna go into the oldie secret room. Super secret room. Patrick Malone really whooping butt with these golden keys. I love them. Tears upgrade there. We get an Emperor card as well. Definitely ranks on the dunk factor. All right, round two here on floor two. The compost is going to double all of our flies and spiders that currently exist. It'll also turn everything on the ground into flies and spiders. So if you need to recycle stuff and you need damage, then well, compost is gonna be for you. What was once a top tier item is not really top tier anymore, but I still think it can be good. You just have to have the ability. Like, compost is one of those items that's going to make you stronger if you're already strong. But it's not an item that you can reliably depend upon anymore in terms of like just carrying you like you used to. I'm gonna go on the record and just say that the redo on floor two was probably not worth it. Something tells me. Tells me it's not worth our time. Gigante Bean. Just have this rolling army of just bugs and death here. We'll take Humbling Bundada. I think we already maybe had. Oh my god. Bighorn. Bighorn did not make it. Saw our payout already from Humbling Bundle. Actually, that was more contract from Blow than anything. We're gonna take 2020 here just because. 2020 is just going to add more shots that we can focus fire with the beam of Tractor Beam. And if you thought that we weren't powerful already, what are you watching? We are. Anything that gets caught in our beam of death will. Well, I mean, it will die. It's because it's called the beam of death. I'd love to get. If we could somehow get Terra or get Sulfuric Acid, that'd be nice. We could just blast our way through doors and stuff. The shadows. Game was lagging a little bit there too. It was a little bit off. It was strange. I think it's honestly because we have too much crap on the screen from compost. I fly. That's so hard. Thank you, Samson's Chain. Thank you, Samson's Chain. We are capped on tiers, so I will take Jesus Juice. You know, having soul is quite nice. It's not as good as having the compass, but it's like a discount compass. Because at least we know the general vicinity of our boss that we need to go towards, you know? The bomb straight up disappeared. I think there's too many entities on the screen, which is the reason why things are despawning. Again, from mostly compost and all the spiders and flies. Oh, God. Well, if we had a problem with that before, we are going to have it now. Load up here on soul hearts. We'll take marbles. Marbles is actually quite useful here. And D-Bizzle. Come on, D-Bizzle. Yeah, I guess. Come on, D-Bizzle. Come on down, D-Bizzle. And that item room is honestly too far away for me to be bothered. I can't. We don't need a singular item room. We have so many flies around us. Oh my god, we decapitated Chubb. My god. Tinted rock down here. What is giving us... What are we breaking stuff with? Is that just Samson's chain just proccing and I'm not noticing it? Looks like we have a tear effect that's actually breaking things, but I think it's us shooting Samson's chain and hitting, like, it making contact with things. Hey, D-Bizzle, thank you for the singular spider. It's very helpful and useful. We didn't have enough of those already. This Vist that we got from Pokemon, or PokeGo, is tearing things up as well. Lil Dumpy. What's good, Lil Dumpy? I think that's what's happening. Legitimately, I think that's what's happening. We're shooting Samson's chain, and it's colliding with environmental objects and breaking it, making it look like it's giving us the illusion of us having a tear effect that can break rocks and stuff. Okay, Bizzle, we're gonna have to start having a little talk here. Kind of hoping for harps. I wanted D-Bizzle to have a chance of redemption, but that's not going to happen. Ace of hearts. Have anything that we can turn? Yeah, there we go. I would say that is a satisfactory amount of hearts. It's not what I would consider to be the best amount, but it's a satisfactory amount. I will allow that, D-Bizzle. Not your best performance, but it's okay. There we go. That goes Mama. And this is still not a great boss rush, but you know what? I'll take the belly button to give us a second trinket slot, because I mean it's going to be no skin off our backs to just simply destroy boss rush real quick. So yeah, those tears were disappearing because there's too many things on the screen. I mean, again, it's just an instantaneous beam of death here. Oh no, pin. Yep. We don't even have piercing shots. All right, there you go. That's how you do boss rush. I'm gonna take. We don't need Guppy's Paw. I'm gonna take Book of Secrets. I mean, Daddy Longlegs is great and all. Wow, that was just now Bookworm. Daddy Longlegs is great and all, but you know, having mapping to go along with having Soul already is basically just going to give us full mapping. Not that, of course, we need any help on this run at this point, but you know. Why not, if you're winning, why not make it just even more winning? Winning-y. Having compost just puts... Or having a car battery just puts compost over the top, and the Book of Secrets as well. I mean, giving yourself double activation on everything is just so good. There we go. We're not maxed out on movement speed, so I'm just gonna take movement speed. There we go. There's the full map that I was waiting for. It's definitely registers on the dunk factor though. Whatever this is on the dunk meter where things instantly die, I don't think this is quite an 11. Yeah, the Purgatory. Unfortunately, Purgatory does not stack. I don't know where this is on the dunk meter. It's at least a 9. Let's see what a 9 was as defined by Jasonator. 9. One run on floor 1. Okay, maybe not. Impending Doom. That's an 8. By the end of the run, Invicta is in no danger and can take out any boss fight in the game without hesitation. However, it takes a few seconds every room for the combo to really ramp up. No, not true either. A dunk rating of 10. Instant painful deaths. Invicta brings nothing but smackdown on the game. Bosses die instantly, and you can see more tier effects than floor. That's also not true either. I think this is probably, I would say, an 8 on the dunk meter. We don't have any real flashy effects or anything, and it's certainly not, like, making, like, your eyes bleed or anything like that. Oh, man, Anima Sola. I mean... Anima Sola with car battery against Hush? Yeah, this is not... What you're about to see is about to be not fair. Like, it's not even going to be fair. Like, Hush may not get any attacks off. Unless, of course, it's off cooldown. Hello, Anima Sola? I'd like to speak to the manager, please. I purchased your Anima Sola, and it is not working properly. The aura from the holy poop isn't even visible. All right. Well, that was Hush. Curse the Blind. I think we're going to be okay. Immediately go into a dead end, of course. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure it's like a painful death for... Actually, you know what? It's probably not painful for the game. Now that I think about it. I mean, because it's instantaneous death. You don't feel anything. It's just a snap and you're gone. No time to even react. Oh my god. What was that? Isaac just got torn to pieces, man. Oh god, it hurts, dude. Oh god. Now this might actually crash the game. I shouldn't have done that, but whee! What a start to the week here. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. And, well, no, we're not done yet. We got Delirium. Here's the Maz A. I don't think Soul guarantees the Delirium. I'm pretty sure I've asked this question every single time we found ourselves in the situation. I'm pretty sure that Soul does not betray the location of Delirium, though. Doesn't feel like the right way. Yeah, it's starting to get a little bit choppy. We have so many tiers compressed down into just one singular beam that the game is like, no. This is not something that happens. Yeah, that is not Delirium. Brownie's already dead. I think he's not really going to help us, but it does give us an HP upgrade, so. Oh, we beat one boss, and now we get to see the entire map. There's Delirium. So now, I will say, if you enjoy this video, everyone, make sure you click the like button. I would appreciate it. We're so close to getting to the Lost Week, and if that happens this week, we will be starting it on next Sunday, or this coming Sunday, I guess, depending on how you look at it. So I'm looking forward to it. I'm also a little bit nervous, but hey, there's only one way to do it. That's just to do it. I don't know what that means, but it sounded okay in my head. So hope you had a great start to your week, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing as we finish off Delirium here in this incredibly powerful run from the get-go. And shout out. Honestly, MVP goes to the sacrifice room decision that we did and decided to just rip it. So thank you for watching. Have a great start to your week, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Elvis Kapovic, Jessica Payne, Bake Nico, Dalton Bruce, Marisi, and Satrical. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.